great Lord's Day, second decade in the 21st century. There's no fake news in the good news of Jesus Christ.
No.
There's been a lot of noise about fake news in the airwaves. Fake news is described as news that's false, phony, not what it says it is, or trumped up to suit a particular purpose. Assuredly, the author of such wants the listener to be overwhelmed and change opinion and disposition to that of the authors. The most serious issue concerning fake news, in my humble opinion, is its foundation. From conception, its foundation is faulty, flawed, and frivolous. Since the garden, man and woman have digressed and acted on fake news to their detriment, Genesis 3. It wouldn't be such a stretch to call the serpent the world's first fake news purveyor. If, for no other reason, I wouldn't want to be found conversing with or following anything or anyone who has proven fake.
Oh, have mercy.
May I give one more instance of fake news? The devil had the audacity to confront Jesus with fake news. Recall when Jesus was led, Matthew 4, up of the Spirit in the wilderness to be tempted of the devil. The Holy Scripture says in the 8th through 10th verses, the devil took him up on an exceedingly high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and their glory. And he said to him, all these things I will give you if you will fall down and worship me. Then Jesus said to him, away with you, Satan, for it is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only you shall serve. Oops, there it is. The devil actually said he could and would give to Jesus that which he didn't own. Now that's fake news by any definition. Good news, however, always trumps fake news. The good news is Jesus came, he died for our sins, he was buried, and he was raised in order that we would have eternal life. Now that's good news. Jesus is the rock. I won't stop, despite Satan's shock, like the rest of the Trinitarian flock, onward to the tippy top. Lord have mercy, Dr. Applewhite Jr.